In this video, I'm going to discuss how do you maintain 100% positive feedback, what's worked for me, and how I've been able to so far maintain 100% positive feedback. Stay tuned. All right, hey, what's up, YouTube? It's Jesse, the veteran flipper, coming at you with another video. In this video, we're going to be talking about how do you maintain 100% positive feedback, and personally, what's worked for me, and how I've been able to maintain positive feedback for almost a year now. All right, so I sold this LCD screen display. So I just sold this display about like 30 minutes ago. It's kind of off subject a little bit from the video, but not really, because so this display sold for $25 plus shipping. So I sent the buyer an offer for $25 plus shipping, or it was like $24.95 plus shipping. And the buyer accidentally selected the wrong button, and it's happened multiple times. And I didn't even notice it until he messaged me, and he ended up paying the full price, which was like $40 plus shipping. And he said, "Can I, send a partial refund?" And I was like, "Of course, could send it right now, because you sent an offer, and that's the price that you agreed to sell it for." So obviously, I sent it, and it's like just little things like that. Go a long way. And then it's things like, all right, so I'll sell an item, right? Like a collectible, and I'll have other collectibles that I don't even intend to sell on my eBay store that just have either a poor sell-through rate or just not worth that much money. And sometimes what I'll do is I'll throw them in and with the item that sold. And it's worked out for me very well, and buyers are very happy to see that they got a free item. Yeah, I'm definitely not saying like go ahead and like give away free items like if you can't afford it. But we're talking about items that I wouldn't even honestly try to sell. I would probably just either redonate or just dispose of. So we're talking about items like that, And some of the items, they're just really bad sell-through rate. I wouldn't list it on my store. I'm very picky about what I do list on my store. I try to list items that only have, maybe a 70, 80% sell-through rate or higher. Most of the time I try to shoot for 100%, but that's not realistic all the time. All right, and way number two that I have been able to maintain 100% positive feedback comes with, very basic stuff, but it's having the discipline to just do it over and over and over again. Like me, I ship every single day, Monday through Friday. I don't ship Saturday and Sunday. And that worked out, it works out for me and my business. If it doesn't make sense for you to ship every day, I know a lot of resellers, even full-time resellers, that ship Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays. But for me, I ship every day, and buyers love that. I get a lot of good reviews, a lot of good positive feedback for shipping every day. Another thing is how well I package. I've discussed this in multiple other videos. I use a lot of bubble wrap, and to make sure the item gets there well, and the buyer feels like, one, they were taken care of, their item was taken care of, whenever you use a sufficient amount of bubble wrap or packaging material instead of just half-assing it and using a little bit of, I don't know, freaking paper towels or, it's just not enough stuff. All right, and another way that I feel like I've been able to maintain 100% positive feedback is because I respond to messages very quickly. Every single morning, one of the first things I do is customer service. I respond to messages. I respond to any return requests, which I haven't had any in a long time. Knock on wood. I think there's wood right behind me. But I'll tell you right now, respond to messages quickly, respond to offers quickly, like act like you're treating the customers like they are your number one priority. Because really, at the end of the day, like the way you respond, the way you treat your customers will take care of you. They will take care of your pocket as well. All right, and the next tip that I got on maintaining 100% positive feedback is something that I personally do. I've actually never heard of another reseller that did this, and it's almost like a psychological thing that a buyer feels that they've been like extremely taken care of, in my opinion. And that is, sometimes an item will show up and it's not what the buyer was expecting. You know, it's either, you know, I don't know. I don't want to say item is not as described, or maybe it showed up with a scratch on it or a slight dent that wasn't there, or something happened, maybe even neglect from USPS or UPS or whatever. But whatever the case is, you know, it just either the buyer just wasn't fully happy with it, and they're gonna either ask for, hey, can I get a partial refund? Otherwise, I would like to return it. And then what I like to say is, I'll say this. Pretty much, I'll say it almost like this, word for word. I'll say, would you like a full refund, or would, no, excuse me, would you like to return the item for a full refund, or would you like a partial refund that you believe is or that you feel is a fair amount? Something along those lines. I'll say that. And most of the time, they'll be like, they'll either throw out an offer or throw out a partial refund that they think is fair, or they'll kind of ask and clarify, because I don't really know if they even get asked that question all the time. I feel like a lot of buyers don't get asked, what do you think is a fair refund? And that's something I've been doing probably for maybe about a year and a half, 2 years now. I've been asking that question, and it's crazy. Like a lot of times I'm like, I sold this item for $200, $300. I'm more than willing to refund $50, $100, whatever it is. And I'll be like, how much do you want for a refund? And they'll be like, $10. I'm like, $10? I'm like, that's literally nothing. I'm like, and a lot of times they'll be like, oh, can you do $10? Can you do $20? And I'll just go ahead and send them $25, $50, you know, for a refund. That way they feel like, oh yeah, things didn't go my way and I got what I asked for, but I really wish I would have got more. You know what I mean? Like, you know, like, it's just weird the way people think sometimes. So me personally, I'd rather just make them feel like they got a good deal, you know, things didn't work out, I refunded them very fairly. And it doesn't always work out like that, you know. Once in a blue moon, I'll hear someone say something crazy like, oh, can you refund $100? And I'm like, no way. Like, just go ahead, you know, I might as well just get the item back. But almost that almost never happens. Like, you'd be extremely surprised. And I'm telling you, that's worked out very well for me. And it's another little trick that's helped me, you know, maintain. One, I'm maintaining the sale still. It's obviously still profitable for me, even to send that partial refund. And with that being said, like, you gotta really not think like small. Like, don't think small. Don't worry about a $25 return, or even a $100, not return, but a hundred, $25 partial refund, or don't even think about a $100 refund, partial refund. You know, you should be thinking, instead of $100, you should be thinking about $1,000. Instead of $1,000, you should be thinking about $10,000. That's how my mind thinks. Like, you know, I want to make sure that the customer is happy with the item. That way, you know, later down the road, they're not coming back pissed off, asking for you know, a full refund, and now I gotta worry about the item coming back. And what if what if it's an expensive item that sold for, you know, $200, $300, or even $1,000? You know, I sold multiple collectible items for anywhere from $700, $800 all the way up to $1,000, over $1,000. You know, and imagine a person like that sending the item back, not caring about packaging it right, and now it shows up broken. You know, now you got to deal with that. So that's a little pro tip that's worked for me. If you got anything from the video, please consider liking and please consider subscribing. I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.